Hello everyone, and welcome back to Naysmith Gaming. I'm the Naysmith, here to give you a game to enjoy and some questions to think about. As we are returning to Civilization VI, the topic of the day is the nature of conflict.
In the beginning, legends of flying men soared. And today, you are on the brink of transforming those legends into a reality. With flight and new forms of communication, you can create a small and intimate world. But at what cost? Our competing ideas of how to govern and how to live threaten to bring conflict on a global scale. You must choose your own path through this rising din of ideological oratory.
When last we left off, I was preparing my armies for what I had hoped was going to be an invasion of England, but due to Bristol's placement, he was going to actually be going after Persia. I was also building up my technology and economy. Ah, here we are. This one's going to be very important. Catches, I need plastics in order to get access to this oil here. Fortunately, I can get some oil here anyway, not as much as I would like. I'm probably going to rely heavily on coal power. Taking a quick look at the score. It appears I'm winning by a decent margin, and Cyrus, Persia, is next in line. Eight cities. Okay. Against my five, but only four of them are built up. Need 240 gold. Plenty of niter there. This looks like a small habitable area. I should probably place a settler. I'll give you up both the grapes. Put it there, but it'll give me oil. I don't think that one needs to be named. Oh, can I purchase with faith? No. Well, I sort of can, but not what I want to purchase. Might as well spread the religion there. I'm going to avoid building things next to the volcano if I can avoid it. Wait, how did my courser take so much damage?
There are three things extremely hard. Steel, a diamond, and to know oneself. War is hell.
Actually, no, I don't want to change my policies. First, let's... go there. Okay, then the sealed cannon. I think actually I will use this. He has 8, okay. I have 2. Oh, my engineers can repair? That is wonderful. It occurs to me that... seriously. Oh. That was them fighting. Okay. Occurs to me that I could use this guy to build a tunnel at some point later, which would let me go after Liverpool. That'll give me access to these. So that's gonna be on my to-do list. Now I know where plastics is. Oh, of course. I need to get replaceable parts. Which will in turn go there. I have a Muscovite core. Let's go to Sparta, build another couple of Muscovites. Try and get that boost. Ooh, that ranger might find me. I just dropped from 6 to 3. What? That's weird.
The class struggle necessarily leads to the dictatorship of the...
so I'll lose one of my wildcard slots. In exchange for... yes. Let's go for that. I lost some bonus gold, but I can get it back from here, or at least part of it. Might as well. Computers? Ah. Finally, over there. Don't you dare pillage. No. I'm keeping that oil. Don't you dare pillage. Like that. No, I'm not trading my oil. Especially, I know that's France, not England. Still not trading my oil. Oh good, all I did was attack my team. Oh, yes, absolutely this. Just go there and skip until next turn. Stronger now. Power 74. There's not a single. Okay. I'm getting close to where I should, in fact, attack. Colossus. Okay. I have no objections to that.
The first time I stepped onto the rooftop of the Portella Palace, I felt, as never before or since, as if I was stepping onto the rooftop of my being, onto some dimension of consciousness that I'd never visited before.
That's a huge boost. A city here will allow me to do a two-pronged attack of sorts. My note here will be very useful.
No one starts a war, or rather, no one in his senses ought to do so, without first being clear in his mind what he intends to achieve. All other lands found on the western side.
I'm going to need to upgrade my governors soon, or promote them. Level 3. Talent roads. I'm saving the last one for when I need a boost, and for when I have the space for him, because I need 6 cities to use all my governors.
all works on natural history, we constantly find details of the marvelous adaptation of animals.
Now Persia is going to find their conquest of Nazca not nearly as easy as they had hoped.
Cars haven't advanced that much since we were kids.
Purchase a lighthouse, and then I will purchase a trader. Decent bonuses, the 3 science and 8 more gold, but I really want that food and production. Once I've built up this today to be something semi-decent, I'll be able to... I'll be confident enough to make that full two-pronged attack. Especially since they seem to be going full combat, full theological combat towards each other. Crystal. I'm going amphitheater. I actually need to go over to here. I'll soon have a railroad that can take me next to Bristol. I will now be at plus 2 per turn. But you know, a tank core. Yeah. I'm gonna win soon. No, I'm not going to give up that much oil. Not anytime soon. This is why I'm not entirely bothered.
Chemistry is the dirty part of physics.
Ah, I can build mountain tunnels now. I'm not entirely fond of the warrior class unit, or the melee upgrade tree, mostly because after I get after musketman, infantry, maintenance, and not maintenance, consumes 1 oil per turn. That is, I want to like it, but I can't. I'm now consuming 2 oil per turn, which means I'm only getting 1, so yeah, I gotta be careful about that. I just realized, no, I cannot get through the mountains here.
Destroying rainforest for economic gain is like burning the Renaissance painting to cook a meal.
I could go through there, or more likely I could... No, Bologna is stopping me. Okay, gotta go going through Antinarigo for another attack pattern, so once I get Bristol, I'll be able to sweep in two prongs that way. Oh, wait. I just built that far off city-state. Whoops! Logical? I already have a tank. Come
the
on.
Machines are unsmoothly and predictably. It's part.
Grand tank. Trade route. Trade route. Hong Kong wants religious conversion. Yeah, I'll get back to you on that one. It's three trade routes. couple Eurekas. I may also wish to build a mountain tunnel right there. After I've built my rails. This sounds great. Heh. Oil power plants banned? Okay. Yes! Two more victory points.
When they are preparing for war, those who rule by force speak most copiously about peace until they have completed the mobilization process.
It looks like I'm winning diplomacy now, so I might do that instead of conquest, after all. Fortunes have turned. Reina's in Sparta. I think I want her in Pharsalos instead. As much as I don't like losing that wheat, Well, I was gonna have to replace those eventually anyway. No, I'm not trading my diplomatic points anytime soon. No. He's the first one on my list.
If it weren't for electricity, we'd all be watching television by candlelight.
I believe this one has now been banned. Ooh, hydroelectric dam. Nice. Seaport. So I can get nuclear fission before I get uranium. That checks out to me. I've been preparing for conflict with Persia. Except that sudden increase in diplomatic victory points means something I'm doubting that I want to. This volcano erupted. Ah, lost one from my thesis. Okay. I am leading the World's Fair by a long shot. Oh, let's delete this map tack, because I no longer need it. Okay, I really like both of these. I'm probably going to use them. Why would they build a quadrine there? I'm very glad for that. Yeah, let's just go there and wrath him a little. Just by being there. Turns just seem to keep growing longer and longer. In the beginning of the game, I could easily stuff 50 turns into just one playthrough, into just one video. Now, it's more to the order of 20 turns. Looks like they're in a drought. You know, they really should change this a little bit. It's too obvious that there will always be droughts there.
With self-government is freedom, and with freedom is justice.
Okay, looks like I'm switching from military to diplomatic.
If you go on with this nuclear arms race, all you're gonna do is make the rubble bounce.
I'll take one turn of not gaining any oil. Wait a minute. I can do that. Thank you. And once I built this improvement here, that'll be about it for the day. Wait. No, it won't. I'll have to finish this industrial zone. And the Forbidden City.
The children of the nuclear age, I think.
Get computers in a random test. Oh, I already had computers. Ah, radio. That's good. Use if I for that. Oh, let's train a tank. I fully intend to build another railroad after this one, going this way. Fall back to recover.
The whole palace complex is built along a central...
Okay, let's get that quick person. I know each of them has some gold per turn, but... I'll have them handy for when someone tries to take over a city safely. I have some housing issues. And that's it for the day. Have a good day, everyone. This is Naysmith, signing out.